Hello, my name is Jesus Medina, and I'm the creator of KO Method, which is a holistic approach to fitness and self-defense training. I'm also the owner of Seabreeze Fitness, which is located in Costa Mesa, California, which is where I'm recording this. Today, I'm going to go ahead and share with you guys a little bit of how to counter a southpaw jab straight combination as an orthodox fighter, as an orthodox stance. Alright, reason why I'm doing this is in relevance to Canelo versus Lara. Alright, today we're going to emphasize on Canelo's one way to eliminate Lara's magnificent 1-2. Now, this is only my opinion. I believe that Lara has 10 times better straight than Mayweather does. Alright, but Lara is a lefty, right? So it's a completely different thing, but the thing is, that doesn't mean that I think that Lara is 10 times better than Mayweather. Hell no. I do will tell you this much though, I believe that Lara or Rigondeaux, both being left-handed boxers, and Thorman are the only ones that really right now that truly have a chance with Mayweather. Now Thorman, yeah, he has a lot of power, he's fast enough, but he has too much power in the sense that I think it's too much power for Mayweather. I think, you know, it's something that I learned from judo is that finesse and speed will always trump power. Always. Doesn't matter how big you are, if a small person knows what they're doing, they have speed and finesse, they will overcome that power. Why? Because you take the center of gravity, all kinds of stuff. Anyhow, the point is the Thorman, I don't know, I think he would make a magnificent, brilliant fight against Mayweather, but I don't know, I feel he might have a little too much power for Mayweather in the sense that he might be a little too slow on his feet for Mayweather. When it comes to Rigondeaux and Lara though, I believe they have magnificent jabs. They may be boring fighters to some of you because how disciplined they are in their actual technical boxing skills, which makes them somewhat of boring fighters because they don't do too much action pack. They're more used to that point system where, you know, you go in and out a lot of backing up, almost like Mayweather does, but Mayweather's a little more exciting because he's a freaking genius as far as a businessman. You know, he likes to entertain people. Anyhow, the point is we're going to do this in order to show you how you will eliminate Lara's straight left. All right, that's one thing. I don't know if you guys noticed. I believe Lara is freaking one-dimensional. I mean, that doesn't take any away from him. He's a phenomenal fighter, phenomenal boxer, phenomenal warrior at that. All right, but he's one-dimensional in the sense that he doesn't use much uppercuts. He doesn't use much hooks at all. All right, he has a phenomenal jab. Relies on that jab, and that jab really does the work. All right, his jab actually will hurt. His jab is quick enough to misdirect, to keep you at bay, and to keep setting himself up for his shots to keep you thinking. All right. Anyhow, so Lara does that jab straight combination. That 1-2 combination, straight left. Combination, all right, very, very wisely, very smartly, very quickly, all that good stuff. And he does that jab a lot, so he sets up that a lot. But the point is I've been watching his fights a lot, and he's good to his right. Why? Because naturally, it crosses over the straight, all right, the left. All right, he has hit people on this side, all right, whether they're southpaw or orthodox, but the point is he's less accurate on this side, he's more accurate towards his right. Alright, because it just crosses over. Now, Canelo obviously won't be on that side because he's an orthodox. So, we're going to show you how Canelo can eliminate that jab straight, alright, and then set himself up for a counter for that, alright, or maybe even counter that jab straight that Lara does a lot constantly and very, very effectively because he's so quick. And he, not only that, last thing is, he has a phenomenal reach, and he knows how to use it. Anyhow, so today I got Warrior Steven here. He's going to be playing the part of Canelo, meaning an orthodox fighter, orthodox stance. I'm going to be Lara, meaning southpaw stance. All right, but I will show you, we will show you both how an orthodox will counter both a southpaw and an orthodox jab straight combination. First, we'll show you really quick, get it out of the way, how an orthodox would do it for an orthodox. Sometimes, the reason why I want to show that is because sometimes the orthodox counter southpaw straight left, can also work, I mean, a straight right can also work for the southpaw and vice versa. But not against Lara, because again, Lara is really good on the right side because it crosses over. Anyhow, so here we go. Orthodox. So for an Orthodox, let's see, get on that side, because that way they can picture themselves as the actual fighter, as them watching me, me being the opponent. So, all right, Orthodox, all right, naturally, my straight is going to cross over towards your guys' right, or his left. His right. Your guys' right. Anyhow, so it's going to cross over this way, right? The jab is going to go either straight or a tiny bit towards the left, never towards the, a tiny bit towards my right, your guys' left. So this is what it's going to look like, all right? Jab, straight, all right? That's what it looks like, right? But the way you're going to eliminate, or one way you will eliminate that shown, if you were in stance, the dip under, so bam, bam, all right? That's what you would do if you knew that your boxer doesn't charge too much, stuff like that. But Lara has a huge straight, long straight. So I'm going to show you, even though it's an Orthodox, I'm going to show you what to do with the long Orthodox straight. So what you would do is, go ahead and do it real quick. So boom, boom. All right. So he's, look at that, how much distance he has. Go ahead and throw that straight. All right. Without even trying, he can reach me big time. All right. Go back to where you were. Is anywhere near? All right. Right here. Again, I have to position this way. Set myself up and then attack, or I can try to attack from here, but I'm gonna be left way off balance and he's already loaded up, cocked, ready to go. So I'm gonna collide into that punch, just like Pacquiao did against Juan Manuel Marquez. Now, whether Juan Manuel Marquez was taking steroids at that time or not, I believe it's bullshit, or I think you're an idiot. I'm sorry to say, if you think that steroids created that knockout, all right? It's simple, well, I wanted to say simple physics, but it is physics, but it's simple common sense. Pacquiao always does that straight, jab straight. So Juan Manuel Marquez timed it perfectly, all right? And yes, she got lucky, all right? And Pacquiao ran into that crazy, professional, crazy looking straight from Juan Manuel Marquez. So it wasn't no steroids or anything like that that knocked out Pacquiao. It was a well-timed and, yes, lucky shot, all right, that Marquez did, and Pacquiao knocked himself out in a sense. He ran into that punch. Play it over if you don't believe me. Anyhow, so here we go, one last time. So what's going to happen is, simply, you're just going to, let's go sideways this way. So all he's going to do with this lead foot is step to his left and a little bit back. That's gonna create enough distance so that I can hit with the jab. All right, if you don't do that, if you stay there, I can hit him with my jab. All right, if he doesn't, that's gonna make me move a little bit back. Go ahead and I'll step over. Right. So now I have to step over, right? So now here, after you shoot the straight, go do what you need to do right there. So that's all he does. That's what it looks like from the side, right? You're not just stepping straight over to the left. You're not stepping to me. All right, like you would if I was throwing a straight, boom. Because then right there you can throw an uppercut or anything, a hook or whatever. But anyhow, so let's go back to this side now. So now we're going to show you what the pivot looks like. All right, so same thing. This is taking care of the jab, the distance. There's no way he's going to get hit, and he's slipping as well. All right, now I'm going to throw the straight. All right, I threw it to his head. Now I'm off balance. All he did, go back again. So all he did was step back, boom.